Hey guys, it's that Dividend guy coming at you with another Robinhood portfolio update. Happy Wednesday. Hopefully everybody's having a GGD, a great green day in the market. You know, I always wish the best for my viewers and subscribers. So guys, we're going to go over the overall portfolio value, how it's performing by the metrics, our buying power, then our individual stocks and how they're performing, as well as Berkshire and my plan for that on my watch list. So jumping in, for today, we're up a little over $900, a 1.67% return. That 1 week mark, we are up $2,700, a 5% return in the past week. Then that 1 month mark, we're up $3,200, a 6% return for the past month. Then on that 3 month mark, we are up $6,700, a 13.4% return. Year to date, we are up $6,800, a 13.74% return. So matching about what I did on that 3 month mark. Then that 1 year, we are up $8,100, up nearly 17%. Then all time, we are up $21,337.49, a 60% return since 2018. So guys, overall, the portfolio value is sitting at $56,670. Of course, that's going to fluctuate just simply because the market is open right now. But this is the most green and the highest that we've ever been at 56K. So our buying power is sitting at $229.85. Guys, I'm going to let that sit, and I'm going to let AbbVie and Apple and Realty Income pay me next month, and we'll see what deals we have within the portfolio at that time, and we'll try to take advantage of the stock that's the best buy for me right now. My goal is to buy more Coca-Cola, more Apple, and more Visa. So as of right now, at current prices, I believe since yesterday, Visa was the best buy, but we'll see how stocks are sitting when we get those dividend payments. So that buying power of $229.85 will be going up as of next month, but I'll be letting it sit and accumulate a little bit more cash so we can buy some more stocks. Jumping right in, we've got Realty Income sitting at $57.64, up $1.20 today. 170 shares, right around $9,800 of market value. Average cost is $65 per share. 17% of the portfolio is in Realty Income. Today we're up $217. Total, we're still down about $1,200, down 11%. But guys, we've been down as low as like 19 to 20% on this holding. So even though we're still in the negative, we're more positive than we have been for a while. Not sure why it's actually going up. I haven't seen acquisitions or anything in the news lately. I haven't seen anything about interest rates, but we'll see. Overall, I mean, I knew that this dip wasn't going to last forever, and I did take advantage a little bit. So I'm excited to see where the stock goes in the next, you know, couple of years. It'll take a while for interest rates to fully shift and have that reflected in the market. So I still think, you know, our average cost is 65, so I have an opportunity here. Even though it is going up, I still have a pretty good buying opportunity here for Realty Income. Then we've got Altria, near $50 a share, up $1.40 today. 320 shares, $15,800 of market value. Average cost is $47.27, 28% of the portfolios in Altria. Today we're up $400, total we're up nearly $700 with a 4.5% return all time. So guys, this is one of those that I don't mind if it's up, I don't care if it's down. I'm in it for the passive dividend income, so right now I wouldn't purchase any more. But that's a rarity. Usually this stock is down, so it is rare to see it up. That is probably partly why the portfolio is performing so well. Realty Income is usually the lagger, and so is this. Those two, being Realty and Altria, are usually what are holding the portfolio back. So since they're both gaining, I'm not surprised to see a little bit of green here. But you guys know the goal of Altria is just to keep building that passive income and buy me a share of Apple or Visa every quarter. It does that very well. If I get some gains, some green on top of it, that's even better. Next up, we've got Coca-Cola at $65.32. Everything looks like it's been up a buck today. 15 shares, around $980 worth of market value. Average cost is $60.54. Around 2% of the portfolio is in Coca-Cola. Today we're up $15, total we're up $71. So it is a little bit out of my buy range. I wanted it around $65 per share, which it is, but I wanted to cut it off at $65 even. So I wouldn't purchase it here at these prices, but I do love Coca-Cola. It will be one of the big three eventually. But I'm good to sit and wait for a little bit of pullback before I purchase any more shares here. Then we've got what I want to be the biggest position in the portfolio, Apple, which is actually down today, around $230, down $5 today, five shares, $1,100 of market value. Average cost is around $210 per share. 2% of the portfolio is in Apple. Today we're down $27. Total, we're up nearly 100 with a near 10% return. Guys, this is going to be the biggest single position in the portfolio. I wouldn't mind it being 15 to 20% of the portfolio. At 2% right now, we have a lot more to buy, but I'm excited for it to keep growing, and this will be the single biggest position, followed by Visa, and then I want it to be Coca-Cola. So I would buy at these prices. I wouldn't buy at these prices, but it's not at a terrible price right now. I did buy it at like 230 something. So, I mean, this is below what will be my average cost. Yeah, I bought it at 228, so right around these prices. But as I've said in a past video, my goal with Apple is to just have enough cash. So if I have five shares, I want five shares worth of Apple in free cash to transfer over and buy at a lower price. So my goal is to mirror my cost, my total market value with Apple in my savings account or my investment account, and transfer it over and cost down average and double my position at a lower cost. Then AbbVie's at 174. Dang, AbbVie is positive what Apple is negative today. 95 shares, $16K worth of market value. Average cost is $95.20. 30% of the portfolio is in AbbVie. Today we're up $500. Total we're up $7,500 with an 83.5% return, with a dividend coming in of $147.25. Guys, this dividend started out at $1.07, and this is by far the best performing stock I have in the portfolio. This is doing the same thing that Altria is doing, and that what T. Rowe Price will be doing, which is buying me a share of whatever pays me next month. So Altria will buy me a share of Apple or Visa, depending on prices. Then AbbVie will purchase a share of T. Rowe Price, and if I can eventually afford it, a share of Visa, and then T. Rowe will buy me a share of Coca-Cola. So overall, guys, the main strategy of the portfolio is this month buys next month, and it just, my passive income goes up every single month. And AbbVie is by far the best performing stock that we have, and I'm going to just let it keep growing. A lot of people would take that $7,500 and put it into something else. I'm going to let the stock run up and keep getting that dividend payment. Then we got Visa up $2.81 today. We've only got one share as of right now. I don't know why it's not showing my... I know there's been some issues with Robinhood, but I only have one share here of Visa. Let me see if I can get that. Yeah, that's really weird. It is not showing my... Anyway, we only have one share, so it's at 272. I know I am up on the stock, but it is near my average cost, so I would buy at these prices. Next, we've got T. Rowe Price. Funny that it only didn't do it for Visa, but that's fine. Then T. Rowe Price, we have 100 shares, $11,800 worth of market value. Average cost is around 110 per share. 21% of the portfolio is in T. Rowe Price. Yeah, obviously Robinhood's having issues because, see, at the top it switched to AbbVie. But about 21% of the portfolio is in T. Rowe Price. Today we're down 230. Total we're up 871 with an 8% return. So guys, I'm not sure what's going on with Robinhood, but overall, guys, it is above my average cost. I wouldn't purchase more T. Rowe here since it's about $8 above my average cost, but it does its job. It does buy me at least a share or two of Coca-Cola every time I get paid. Then Berkshire, I've said it in past videos, my new goal for Berkshire is just to do a share every single Christmas. So 2018, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So I owe myself about, I think it's like $3,200 worth, yeah, $3,100 worth of Berkshire. I don't have that right now in free cash, but I will eventually get my seven shares. So guys, we're at an all-time high of 56K. I'm super excited to see where it goes. I know it's going to fluctuate. It won't stay this high forever, but it is cool to hit an all-new high. Before it was 55, like 3 days ago, I think, and now it's at 56. So I'm really happy with that. And the dividends keep coming in and growing too. So Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to hit the subscribe button on my channel, That Dividend Guy. Hit the like button on this video. It does really help. Each individual video that you guys like, it does boost up my chances of being seen, and it helps other people see the content. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you tomorrow with another Robinhood portfolio update. Take care, guys.